Welcome to Psychic Medium Toni Green. I am Toni Green and I will be hosting the show today as I do every show. You know what? I'm going to be honest with you. I spent like 5 minutes, which were clearly five wasted minutes, practicing this perfect intro and I can't remember it. So what I get for practicing it in bed, right? So here, throughout this show, I'll be taking callers, answering questions about life, love, career, finances, and helping you connect with loved ones on the other side. If you'd like to call in, the number is 845-277-9131. I'll be happy to take your call, answer your questions, and or help you connect with loved ones on the other side. I know sometimes when people call in and they want to connect with a loved one, they have an expectation of a certain response or statement or answer from their loved one. Please be open to what the loved one is giving you, because oftentimes, even though what you want is important, what they're saying might be more important. So last week, Michelle called in and was asking about something. And the person who had passed was there and giving messages. And at the end, you know, she really just wanted this one specific answer. And sometimes spirit doesn't play with your ego. If you're bringing your ego to the table, spirit's like, no. Mm-mm. But Michelle, after the show, I was thinking about it and trying to get the answer you were looking for or that you specifically wanted. And Daisy, the only thing I get is it's innocent and the statement pushing up daisies. Now, does this have something to do with you or your grandchildren? It could possibly. But I just keep getting daisies are innocent. I hope that answers your question, and I hope it helps you on your journey of the person that you lost. And I am sorry for your loss, okay? So having said that, in a moment, I'm going to get started taking callers. Please have a specific question available. I'll do my best to answer that question about life, love, career, finances, any aspect of your life at all. And if you want to connect with a loved one, I just need their first name and their relationship to you. Now, as I often do at the beginning of the show, I am going to give a few messages. I made notes. I made notes because I knew I would forget all of this. And for those who need to know in advance, I will be singing on this show. So if you have sensitive ears, you might want to, you know, cover them when I sing. If there's a song you want to hear, let me know. I'll be happy to sing it. And no, I will not change my show for you that do not want me to sing. If spirit is bringing music through me, I'm going to sing my ass off. And that's all there is to it. Okay. So the first song I'm hearing on that note, the first song I've been hearing all weekend, people, this song, and whatever people this song is for, you are going to know instantly. I'm hearing that verse, one verse of the song that says, I'm not the one who's so far away when the snake bite enters something in the vein. So that is the first song coming through. Can I sing a happy tune? Yes, I can, Sal, and I will. I'm not sure who sings that song, but I know that those are the words that I'm getting. I'm not the one who's so far away when the snake bites. And then the other song, and Sal, this one's for you. I guess this one must be for you. I'm walking on sunshine. Woo! And don't it feel good? And I'm serious, that is a song that was coming to me. There are other songs that'll be coming throughout the show. I won't always be able to give the warning to cover your sensitive ears, but hey, I'll do my best. I don't want to upset anybody for any reason. And I had a session with somebody who I know watches the show often, and I was going to text you some information. And I ended up trying to text it to a landline. So it's called, I think it's called friendpc.com is what you're looking for. Okay, now to my notes. As I try to read that, I'm going to my notes. Okay, this is about, the first one is about relationships. And this is just a little relationship wisdom. Now, this can be with a friend, a partner, or even at work. The worst thing you can do is feel sorry for someone or a situation, because once you feel sorry for someone or a situation, it just cripples you. It cripples you. You can no longer do what's best for you. So if you're feeling sorry for your partner, if you're feeling sorry for a friend, if you're feeling sorry for your boss or your company, you are now crippled. And especially if you're empathic and you can no longer do what's best for you in the situation. And that, my friend, is not good. So really try to remove those emotions. Try to understand why you have that pity or you feel sorry for someone. And 9 times out of 10, people would be insulted if they knew you felt sorry for them. Really, they would, unless they're manipulative. If they're intentionally telling you things to make you feel sorry for them, that's called motive. And they're trying to get you in that space where you are, giving to them or doing something for them. Okay, so don't let that happen. That's note number one. Okay, if you ever feel confused in a relationship, a friendship, work, anything, it's because, let me tell you, it's just because you're not getting all the information. And again, that's a very intentional thing that someone is doing to you for their own motives. They want you to be confused because they're trying to either get away with something or do something or whatever. So if you're in any situation with a friend, with a partner at work, and you're confused, it's because they are intentionally not giving you all the information. Communication is here. Communication is a necessity, and clear communication, if I can pull it off this morning, let's find out, is so important. And most people want to have clear communication and they want to make sure you understand what they're saying or what's going on in a situation. So if you feel confused in a situation, if you feel like you don't know what's going on, it, trust me, it's because the other person doesn't want you to know. And that is, again, a very intentional thing. It's like, it's a form of manipulation. I'm not going to do that one right now. Okay. I know what I was trying to say here, but I didn't write it all down, so I'm having a little bit of trouble remembering all of it. Yes. Okay. There's a difference. Male, female, doesn't matter. There's a difference between somebody that wants you and somebody that is ready for you, or somebody who actually wants an actual relationship with you. So we can see something, whether we see it in a store, on a showroom floor, and we can want that. Okay, it doesn't mean we're ready for the responsibility. Like a lot of us would like a Bentley or a G-Wagon. I don't really, what's a G-Wagon, folks? It's in a lot of songs and it just came to me. I just, G-Wagon, G-Wagon, G-Wagon. Yeah, I don't really know what a G-Wagon is, which probably says a lot about me and my culture and where I am right now. However, but we're not ready for the responsibility, or we don't want the responsibility that goes with that. So there can be people out there that really want you and they want to have the benefits of you, but they don't want the full-time responsibility of being in a relationship. And those, to those people, keep it pushing, keep going, keep window shopping. Find somebody who's on that page. But if you're not on that page, make sure that whomever you are with is ready for that full-on relationship experience with you, if that's what you want. Okay, I'm going to go to callers. Again, if you'd like to call in or join us live, the number is 845-277-9131. Kim, I just left a website for you. So hopefully that's helpful. I believe it will be. It will be. I believe it will be. I'm going to go to callers. If I say your area code, please have an exact question or connection available for me. And also, I'm going to come back and take questions on the chat. Okay. So I'm going to start with 703-703. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
Hi, my name's Andrea. I'm calling from Virginia.
Excellent. How can I help you today?
Well, I'm on a contract job and it ends in about 3 weeks. So do you see me getting a new one, hopefully before this pay decent?
Yeah, I instantly hear yes. And I instantly hear you should, given the fact that you're out there looking, it should be within 2 weeks. And I hear the word repeat. So I don't know if that means it's, all right then. The words are in my head, but they're apparently stuck there, not coming out of my mouth. I hear 2 weeks, I hear repeat. And so I don't know if that means that they might repeat the contract where you are, or it's going to be exactly like the contract you're already in, perhaps with somebody else. But I do feel like it's going to be a repeat, or someplace you had a contract in the past. I'm not sure what repeat means, but you'll know when that comes in. But I do feel like you'll know within 2 weeks. And I do feel like you're going to be, it's going to put, I see it putting a smile on your face. I see you being happy about this contract. Okay, love?
It's funny you say repeat, because I had an interview with Keller Williams in September when I first lost my job. And they, I guess because the money was not there, the money that I wanted. So I have an interview with the same Keller Williams office, different capacity on Wednesday, but also the money is not what I want. So maybe that's why you say repeat. I mean, it's just not, the salary is not what I want, but it's an opportunity that's better than unemployment.
Yeah. And I do think whatever this is, whatever's coming in for you, it might be a repeat of something you've already, either the, maybe it is the interview or maybe it's the contract coming in. Either way, I feel like you're going to know within, I want to say 2 weeks. I hear a month you'll be in the position. Okay. So we'll see. Okay, love?
Okay, great. I'll let you know how it goes. Thank you.
Perfect. You're so welcome. You have an amazing rest of the day, okay?
You too. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Okay, I'm going to go directly to 405. 405, what's your name? Where are you calling from?
Hey, Toni, it's Heather from Oklahoma.
Hey, Heather, how are you?
I'm good. I was going to ask you about Lillian, because she's having issues with her heart, too. So I didn't know if she was going to have the same stuff going on like Colin did.
So let me take a moment and look at that. I was asking, I was getting other information while you were asking, so I'm going to take a moment and look at that.
Okay.
Okay, I do feel like she is going to have, obviously, you know, she's going to have problems with her heart. I don't think it's going to be the same thing. I think it might be similar, but it's going to be different, okay? I feel like, now I'm not completely familiar. I'm just going to tell you what I'm getting. And again, yes, we all know I'm not a doctor. I'm not trying to be a doctor. I'm getting there might be a blockage, or like I'm seeing like this, like if there's a valve and there's this thing that's supposed to, something's not fluttering, like something's not fluttering, like open and close the way it's supposed to. I don't know.
Yeah.
You'll have to let me know when she goes in and finds out. I feel like you're going to know about this within a month. I feel like within a month you're going to know.
Yeah.
We
looked at it. You're supposed to have 3 valves, and hers is like 2.5.
Okay.
So the one valve is like fused to the other valve.
Okay, and is that, okay, so then what, they're going to want to do, they're going to want to do surgery to try to, I hear the song, you gotta keep them separated, to like separate it. I know, right? Spirit is like, Spirit can just be a straight up gangster sometimes. I'm just saying the music they bring through in heavy situations to lighten it for me and for the other person is amazing. I love it because if you're dealing with something really heavy, even though we're taking it serious, we don't want it always to be like, oh, you know. So,
doom and gloom, yeah.
Yes, exactly. I'm going to say that they're going to try to create, like I'm hearing create a space, and what I'm seeing something, but there's something with this little, for lack of a better word, this little, like if you have the valve and everything goes in this way, and then this little flap, make sure nothing goes back out, like, something with that. They're going to have a little bit of an issue with maybe with that, but when the time comes, it's all going to get worked out. Now, the first surgeon that you go to isn't the right surgeon, but I think it's either going to be the second or the third. And yes, I know what you're saying right now. Which one? The second or the third? I don't know. right now. Like, give me a minute. The third. Okay, the third. Whew. I feel like the first surgeon might be just like the person who says, yeah, this is the surgery. And the second one might specialize in this. But the third one's going to be the one that actually gets the best results, has done this before. This is a very, I want to say this is a very kind of specialized, I don't think I don't believe this is this surgery has happened before. I believe the person who's going to do it is someone who has done it before, and it's yes, there's that. And don't, you know, she's not going to be the, well, we haven't done this before, but we're going to give it our best shot. That's not the case at all. And don't let that be the case at all, because there is somebody that is a surgeon that is in your area-ish, that is going to be able to do this surgery, that has done it before, and will be able to do it very well. Okay, phew, I said it. There we go. There it is. Okay, phew. Okay, there it is. Okay, got it out. Okay, so that's what I'm getting. I do feel like she's going to be okay. She's going to bounce back, and she's going to be stronger than she was even prior to the surgery. Okay, love?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Awesome. Thank you.
You are welcome, love. And I hope that, please keep us posted, because we're all going to want to know as time goes on how this works out, okay?
Okay, thank you.
You are so, so welcome. Okay, for those of you waiting online, please hold on just a little bit longer. I am going to take a few questions off of the chat because they've also been waiting for quite some time, and I want to make sure I'm being fair with everybody. Hey, Rebecca. Hey, Caroline. So here's what I'm going to do. If I missed your question, please come back and repost your question online. I'm not going to go all the way through back to the top of the chat to get questions. I'm going to do Kate first. Kate, hi, Toni. My dad took me to a ballet, Giselle, one of them, depending on where you're from and how they pronounce G's, I guess, as a kid. And I have been seeing it everywhere. Does Bob have a message for me? Thanks. Yeah, he's just letting you know he's with you, and trying to remind you of sweeter times, of the sweeter times, or of the good things also, the good memories. I just keep hearing the word sweet essence. Okay, like the sweet essence, and possibly of life, but just the sweet essence. Just trying to remind you of the sweet essence of innocence, of childhood, and how, like, seeing those things were larger than life. And if you're not having experiences now, right now in your current life, that don't feel larger than life, to go have those experiences again would be another message that you would get. And I think that message is amazing for everyone. I'm just going to say that. I think that message is amazing for everyone. Rebecca, I love you. I actually miss your singing. Also, what if the songs are in Spanish? Well, Rebecca... Oh, thank you. I love you, Rebecca. I tried to learn Spanish like a million times for many different reasons. And I'm going to tell you, I cannot learn Spanish. I've tried so many times. So if a song comes through in Spanish, well, good luck. I have channeled foreign languages. I've even channeled, I think it's Latin in the past. So it's possible that I think that the closest I could come is that song that goes, uno, dos, tres, I think that is, like, seriously. Yeah. I think that's seriously the closest I could come to a Spanish song. And I have listened to Spanish music, and I still can't. My brain is like, no comprende, no comprende. So I'm sorry. But thank you, Rebecca. I really appreciate that. Walking on sunshine. Yes, Heather. I love my peeps. I love everybody who comes through so strong during the show and brings communication in the chat with each other and with me, and calls into the show. If you would like to call in, the number is 845-277-9131. I go live every Monday and Wednesday at noon. And answer questions. Hey, Modi, how are you? Yes. So I'm going to go to another 405 number. 405, what's your name? Where are you calling from?
Hi, Toni.
Hi there.
This is Natalie calling from Oklahoma.
Hey, Natalie, how can I help you?
Hi. I was wanting to know if my grandparents' estate will be completed this year, if there'll be any issues with it.
Okay, if I instantly hear yes, and I hear, and I see 98. So I feel like I don't know what 98 means, I hear, yes, it will be completed this year. Okay. And then I see or hear 98. So whatever 98 means for that situation, I guess if you don't know now, you will know soon. And I want to let you know that I don't know. I'm not going to try to guess what 98 means, but whomever is in charge of it, I feel like they are waiting on one, possibly two more things, and then it's going to be completed, and everything okay. will be like executed, or the word I'm getting is exhibited, but that doesn't seem right. But if it goes into next year, it will just be that there's the final distribution, or the final thing will be at the beginning of next year. So that is what I'm getting for you, beautiful. I hope that's helpful.
Okay, thank you.
And I do want to say this. There's one complication with this estate, and okay. it might be something that wasn't, I hear the word, foretold. I feel like whomever is doing this is really trying to be logical and fair, but also maybe follow the letter of the law. But there's something that was not very clear, or because some dynamic changed, it changed things. Like, for example, let's just say at the time they made this estate and last will or whatever it is, maybe they had four grandchildren or great-grandchildren. And then by the time the passing came, there were six or seven. I'm just giving a little example here. And then, but in, okay. it says divide equally amongst the four grandchildren or whatever. And there are more now. I don't know. It's like a little technicality like that, where they're trying to follow the letter of the law with this, but also take everyone into consideration. Does that make sense to you?
Okay. Yeah, because my grandparents' children have passed, and then it was left just to grandchildren, and there's five of us, so it's way more complicated now.
Okay, thank you for confirming that, because that is, whomever is doing this really is trying to be just and fair and follow the letter, but it's the verbiage that was there along with the what has happened since then, it is a little bit different. So they're trying to be fair and just, but it's a little complicated. All right, everybody. I love you so stinking much. I hope you have an absolutely amazing rest of the day. I will be back Wednesday at noon. Until then, I just remember how valuable you are.